Some of the information that we need from customers in order to start a design project are things such as, what type of product are we going to be designing? So for example, are we designing a woofer? Are we designing a tweeter? Are we designing a voice communication speaker? And then what is the application for that speaker? One of the next questions that we need to know is related to that, and that is into what environment will this speaker be installed?
So most of the questions that we ask are all about setting limits. So we're basically trying to develop a roadmap to get to what the end design is for the customer.
From a specification standpoint, what we really need to know is what is the performance that they're expecting out of the speaker. We really need to know the size constraints, the impedance that the speaker needs to have to work with the amplifier, the power rating. There are those customers that know that. Then there are those customers that don't know that. And that's okay, because it's our job to help those customers to quantify what it is that they want. For the purposes of this video, I think it's helpful to use a specific example to illustrate how we translate the customer's desires, their specifications, their application into a product. So we're going to talk about a very small, compact subwoofer. The customer specified that the speaker's impedance needed to be 8 ohms, and they wanted the speaker to play down to about 60 hertz. So we had to think about what we'll need to do to design a speaker that'll play that low in that small of a box. The customer has a sensitivity, that is how loud they want this to be. They have a sensitivity rating of 87 dB, which is pretty typical of a compact subwoofer.
The customer's maximum size was 10 inches by 7 inches by 6 inches. So we know that we're going to be targeting probably a 5 1/4 inch subwoofer. We're going to be using a tune port enclosure because that's going to give us better performance in a small enclosure. The customer's amplifier delivers 50 watts into 8 ohms, so we know that the 5 1/4 inch subwoofer that we choose is going to have to be able to move a certain amount or a certain distance, and that's what we call X-max. X-max is the linear one-way movement of a particular speaker. And then we'll also want to make sure that it doesn't move too far, so we'll want to build in the X-mech, which is mechanical excursion.
This enclosure is going to have an internal volume of about 320 cubic inches. 320 cubic inches is about 3.5 liters. We're going to be tuning the box to about 65 hertz, and that should allow us to play down to below 50 hertz. From the driver perspective, the woofer in that box with that tuning alignment is going to need to have a resonant frequency of about 80 hertz and a Q of about 0.55 and 0.6. Now that Q is a little bit higher than what most people think of when they design subwoofers, but we have to keep in mind that because we're designing the driver and the enclosure and the port together, we can make certain trade-offs in the design in choosing those components. So in this particular case, we'll get a nice smooth response low using a little bit higher Q driver than might be traditionally considered. We put all of those parameters, driver parameters together, resonant frequency of 80 hertz, impedance of 8 ohms, power handling of 50 watts, Q of about 0.55, VAS of about 2 liters. Now we have the starting point for designing the driver.
Last but not least, we have the cost consideration. This particular subwoofer needs to be delivered to the customer for less than $100. The reason we're going so far in depth in this example is because these are the things that we need to know in order to design a speaker for any of our customers.
So in our next video, we're going to actually take a look at those parts that were made to the drawings and the specifications that our engineers created.